In recent years, the idea of taxing wealthy individuals' assets, as opposed to just their income, has gained renewed traction. Progressive wealth taxation is frequently proposed as a tool for raising revenue and curbing inequality, but the efficacy of these policies depends on their enforceability. When faced with taxation, to what extent do taxpayers adjust their behavior to avoid it? This paper helps answer that question by studying a series of Colombian tax reforms in the 2000s and 2010s. Colombia has a long tradition of wealth taxation, and taxpayers are required to report their wealth annually. Those above a cutoff are taxed, and this exemption threshold excludes more than 99% of adults. By design, the focus is on taxing those in the extreme right tail of the distribution. This figure shows the wealth taxes structure in 2010. In that year, all individuals with reported net worth below 1 billion pesos owed no tax, while those with net worth between 1 and 2 billion pesos owed a 1% tax. This means that while a taxpayer just to the left of the cutoff owed nothing, a taxpayer reporting just one additional peso owed taxes of over $5,200. Similar discontinuous jumps occurred at 2 billion, 3 billion, and 5 billion pesos. In other years, the wealth tax followed a similar piecewise linear structure, but numerous reforms over the past two decades have modified the precise location of bracket cutoffs and the tax rates between them. This generates periodic changes in individuals' exposure to wealth taxation, and the authors combine this variation with extensive tax microdata to estimate behavioral responses. To start, they show that Colombian taxpayers respond to increases in the wealth tax by immediately lowering their reported wealth below the tax bracket cutoff. In 2009, for example, the exemption threshold was set at 3 billion pesos. This was temporarily dropped to 1 billion pesos in 2010, and two new tax brackets were introduced. These changes sparked an instantaneous response from taxpayers. Here, we see the distribution of tax filers' reported wealth in 2009, and then in 2010. After the reform, there is bunching below the new tax brackets, and the immediacy of this reaction strongly suggests that taxpayers misreported their 2010 wealth in order to fall below the cutoffs. This same dynamic appears for other reforms from this period. In each case, wealth taxation triggers immediate and substantial bunching. Estimates from the 2010 change in the exemption threshold indicate that a 1% increase in the net of tax rate increases reported wealth by 2% for the marginal buncher. Comparing effects across the different regimes suggests that at most 1/5 of tax revenue is lost due to these behavioral responses. Strikingly, these effects persist over time, even when the wealth tax is temporary. The 2010 reforms, for instance, were announced and implemented as a one-year expansion of the wealth tax to meet extraordinary expenses. Taxpayers to the immediate right of the 1 billion peso cutoff were taxed only in 2010. Yet, we see bunching below this threshold in 2010, 2011, and 2012, even though this behavior has no impact on tax liability after 2010. Similar effects appear for other temporary tax changes, and the evidence suggests this reflects strategic behavior. Immediately reverting to pre-reform levels of reported wealth is conspicuous and flagged by the tax authority, so taxpayers remain bunched to minimize the risk of detection. What specific actions by taxpayers drive these effects? The paper sheds light on two key mechanisms used to underreport wealth. First, taxpayers misreport items that are difficult for tax authorities to cross-verify. While most financial wealth in Colombia is subject to third-party reporting, many sources of non-financial wealth are subject to much less. Taxpayers who bunch in response to wealth taxation tend to own more non-third-party reported assets, and they exploit regulatory blind spots by underreporting the items less likely to be detected by authorities. In addition, the wealthiest individuals respond to taxation by hiding assets in offshore tax havens. Data from the leaked Panama Papers reveal that Colombians have created more offshore entities in recent years than wealthier or more populous countries in the Americas, and this trend mirrors the evolution of top wealth tax rates. Wealth tax hikes, such as those that occurred in 2006 and 2010, correlate with stark jumps in the share of ultra-wealthy Colombians offshoring to tax havens. Those not exposed to taxation offshore at lower rates and are fairly insensitive to tax increases. The authors confirm these patterns using their reform-induced tax variation and show there is a causal effect of wealth taxation on offshoring behavior. Thus, this paper highlights important issues for the design of wealth taxes. Effective enforcement requires that tax authorities have comprehensive information on different sources of wealth, and cracking down on offshore evasion is vital. It's also worth noting that individuals may respond to wealth taxation in more gradual and legal ways, such as adjusting their consumption or investment decisions. Beyond evasion, this kind of behavioral response can also diminish the long-run efficacy of wealth taxation. To read more on this topic, you can check out the paper's references to other related work. This includes papers on wealth taxation, including those focused on behavioral responses, and work on tax design more broadly in the developing world.